It has been over 280 days since Russia began its invasion of Ukraine, and we've watched the strength and resilience of the Ukrainian people as help rolls in from around the world.
Yeah, and amongst the tragedy are some remarkable stories, like the Ukraine choir, who continue to perform and record music despite missile attacks. When hearing this, Sydney musician Paul Beard got his band Bluesberries to write this song.
If you are going to listen to that song, a saxophone piece comes in very soon that they really wanted you to hear. Devastated that it cut out in that moment. It's called Blue Sky.
There it is.
There it is. Joins us now, along with fellow muso Daniel Fallon. And in Canberra is the Ukraine's ambassador to Australia, Vasyl Merezhchenko. We welcome you to the show, everybody. And what an incredible moment this is for us to come together and support.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Ambassador, let's start with you. Over 280 days since the invasion, how are the people of your country holding up?
It's extremely difficult for the people of Ukraine. As we know, we have over 6 million Ukrainian refugees in Europe. Another 9 million are internally displaced. So families are separated. Kids are somewhere in Europe going to schools. Now that Russians have attacked civilian infrastructure and have deliberately destroyed power generation, electricity grids, big parts of Ukraine don't have electricity, don't have water supplies. These are war crimes which Russians are perpetrating in Ukraine by hitting civilians and actually putting pressure on Ukraine's political leadership. It's tough, it's difficult, and everybody is affected right now. Of course, it actually unites Ukrainian people even more to fight the brutal Russian aggression and to fight the Russian troops on the ground, which must be expelled. And that's the only way how we can achieve peace.
Oh, most definitely. Paul, we know how much music has influenced people over the years and so emotive and putting things into words that we sometimes find difficult too. When did you first hear about this amazing Ukraine choir and made you, I suppose, write this song?
Well, to rewind back to the beginning, Dan came to me with the idea for the song. And we finished it off in my studio in Glebe. And through Dan's connections, we were able to talk to a lady called Polina in Kiev, who connected us to the Shedrick Children's Choir and the Youth Symphony Orchestra of Ukraine.
Oh, wow. That's unreal. And I think it's just wonderful that your first instinct was to help. I think that is a really big quality in humanity, in which way you go in a disaster. Mm. Dan, as well as a musician, you're a journalist. This song is to help the Ukrainian refugees. How many are there currently, and how are they getting on with day-to-day life?
Well, as Vasyl was saying, there's 6 million people who have had to leave Ukraine, and then another 8 or 9 million people displaced internally. So we've come together to write this song, connect with young Ukrainian musicians who are just so gifted, and write something beautiful. And also, music's a universal language, so we're really trying to connect with people and, in a practical way, raise money to help Ukrainian refugees through UNHCR. What we've come up with, it's been such a long journey, this process, so many Zoom meetings, so much worry because they're under attack. It's a war zone. But these people are so resilient, and they've just, it's been an amazing journey with them. We've grown quite close to them. We can see their anxieties and their worries. But what we've done, and we've come together and we've recorded three music film clips in 4 cities around the world. It's sort of a major amazing project. Yeah. There's like 100 people on the credits. It's a youth symphony orchestra that's unparalleled. Mm. These young musicians from across Ukraine are incredible. And the children's choir, just to see these guys sing this song, it's incredible. And also to mention Mariana Golevko, who's this incredible soprano from Kiev, who was forced to leave when the war first started, and she recorded the track in Berlin. And so it's just been an amazing journey together, and also shows the power of music bringing us together. And we wanted to show our solidarity with the people of Ukraine. Yeah. So, yeah.
I think that's the main thing. And people need to know that there's hands reaching out and trying to help, because not everyone knows how to help.
At this time of year, I mean, you know, they're going into winter with minus 25 degree temperatures, no water, no electricity. So, this is a serious moment.
Oh, most definitely. And in terms of a morale booster as well, Ambassador, a lot of us are learning much about the Ukraine this year. And what we didn't know, it's a very musical country as well. How do you feel as though this song and this support will help boost morale?
Look, it is a very beautiful project of collaboration. Over 70 musicians in Ukraine and in Australia were involved in that, and as well in the UK. So it's really beautiful, because I think the power of music and the music to communicate is important to tell the story of Ukraine. Ukrainian musicians, world-renowned, especially the classical musicians, they are performing at the best venues throughout the world. And those who stayed in Ukraine don't have any sources of income, because they're not performing these days. So it's so important, and it actually tells you a story about Ukraine's resilience, about our ability to get united, and no matter what, to see a positive future and believe in that positive future. And I was really moved when I've seen this idea and this great project, which I have immediately endorsed. I've been exposed to music industry for over 10 years with Eurovision Song Contest, so I really know the music scene really well in Ukraine and in Europe. So I was really pleased to see this project being put together, despite all this huge distance between Australia and Ukraine, and seeing that actually being launched later today. And I very much look forward to the campaign by the UNHCR to raise money for the winter appeal for the Ukrainians.
It's absolutely huge. Tell us about the QR code, because it's so important.
The hard sell. So we've got a QR code that you may be seeing on your screens. Anyway,
there it is.
Please pick up your phone and scan this code. It will go straight to the landing page where you can donate, and you'll hear the music and the videos.
That is fantastic, Paul. Google Blue Skies for Ukraine to hear the song, and head to unrefugees.org.au to donate to the UN Refugee Agency. Ambassador, thank you so much for your time today. Paul and Daniel, thank you so much for this. We'd love to give it more time, but we've got the QR code there. We can all jump on board, and we can all try and do our bit. It's a fantastic...
We're just getting started.
Yeah, this is the start of a campaign. We're going to go around the world. Thanks for having us, guys.
Unfortunately, I'm terrible at instruments, otherwise I'd jump on board.
Bring your tambourine, that's all you need.
Thank you for choosing kindness in the moment when humanity needs it the most, darling.
Absolutely.
We are one.
Peace.
Yeah.
Peace.